Hello everyone, welcome back to another Adobe Photoshop tutorial. This one, I'm going to show you how to take this boring blue sky, this light blue washed out sky, and I'm going to show you how to make it look nice and dark and beautiful and saturated and a nice beautiful blue. So let's get right into this, guys. It is a lot easier than people think, just coming in here and making some changes. So the first thing is if you're working along with me, just throw any old sky in there, and just throw it in and off we go. The next step, guys, is I'm going to just make sure that I'm on the selection tool here, the move tool. I'm going to go up here to select. I am going to now select color range. Here we go. Click. Boom. Now I'm going to go to sampled colors. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to left click on the blue. And you're going to see here that it's selecting the blue, but it's not selecting the clouds. I'm going to hold down the shift key, pardon me, and I'm going to select other parts of the blue. So, whoa, pretty blue, nice and blue. Select that blue over there. And now let's just take a look at the fuzziness. I'm just going to dial this in. I'm just going to try and make this as accurate as possible. So I'm going to go with something like that. So basically we've selected all of these parts here, but you can see the clouds are deselected. Like this here is this cloud and it's blackish in here. So that means it's not selected. These are partially selected, but that's okay because you can see that these clouds are kind of semi-transparent and the blue is going through. So this looks pretty good here. Let's start with that. I'm going to hit OK and bang, this is our selection now. So we're on our way now. The next step, guys, is I'm going to do a vibrance change to it. And now that we've got all these little things selected and you see all the marching ants, come over to the right side here under adjustments, click vibrance. On vibrance, you want to jack the vibrance way up. I'm going to go to 100. And by doing that, and let's just work with the saturation a little. Let's increase it. Yeah, does that look about right? For a lot of situations and for a lot of people, don't ignore the bottom part here. I'm not worried about that. I'm just worried about the top sky. In a lot of situations, that's all you need to do. Done. This is what we started with. This is where we're at. There is a chance, though, that you want a different shade or a different color of blue, and I'd understand that. So maybe you want to go with a darker shade of blue. So the next step, and this is an important one, is you want to go to select, then you want to drop it down and go to reselect. So we've reselected all the area that we had chosen already and we've done the vibrance adjustments to. We're now going to do a hue, a saturation adjustment to it. You want to go back to your adjustments here. You're going to see hue slash saturation. Click on that. Now, this is a little bit delicate, but we want to basically take this hue and we want to go into the blue zone. And let's see, what kind of blue are we looking for? I don't know. I mean, of course, you guys know better than I do. If you want to go way off the rails, right up into the magentas and stuff, go nuts. But I'm thinking something like that, maybe. Then I can adjust the saturation either down or maybe I'll jack it up a bit just because we're going for a really deep, rich blue in this situation. And maybe, yeah, we're going for a dark, rich blue. The lightness, whoa, see, that one goes way nuts. So deal with that one very, very carefully. I'm just going to make it like maybe -2. And then I'm going to just shut that down. And now I'm going to show you, take both layers off. This is the boring original footage that we got. This is it with a vibrance layer. It's got a really nice light blue look to it. I quite like it. And if you guys want to go for that darker blue, you can go in and throw on a hue and saturation. This has a little bit of a purple tinge to it. But again, that's not out of the ordinary. That's a regular sky. And if you don't like it, of course, you can just go in and change the hue saturation. But in basically 3 minutes there, guys, that's how you can take any picture, any photo that has a blue sky and change the adjustment, change the color. You can make it purple or blue or green if you want to have like other effects, guys. But that's how you do it. Thanks for watching. I got a ton of more tutorials coming up. Cheers.